Hi everyone, Rhonda Robson with Rhonda's Tri-RRR-tistry. Today's video, it's all about canvases, different size of canvases, different thicknesses of canvases, and I just wanna teach you what I have learned. There's many different types of canvases out there, and it really depends on how much money you're willing to spend on those canvases. If you're doing experiments, the thinner ones, the smaller ones, less expensive, buy in bulk. If you're doing it for your home or you're doing it to sell, then the thicker gallery wrapped canvases are much better. So for those type of opportunities for you. All right, don't forget to subscribe. Let's get you down on the canvas and let me... Actually, I don't have to get you down the canvas. I'm teaching you about canvases today. What? I don't know. Crazy. So anyway, just a little loopy today. All right. Talk to you later. I'll be right back. Bye, friends. Hi, everyone. Okay, today I want to talk about canvases. And I'm going to go ahead and get you up high already. Instead of being down on the canvas, because I want to explain what kinds of canvases I use. So I use, for the paintings that I put up on the wall or when the ones that I sell, those are the ones that I use are gallery wrapped. I like the thicker inch gallery wrapped. I will use two different types of canvases. I use Master's Touch Fine Arts canvases as well as Artist Loft. When I'm working with Artist Loft canvases, there's two different types of canvases that I've worked with. This one right here, which is a number 3. They also have a number 2 and a number 1. And then they have this series as well that you can get that has a pack of different canvases. And these ones right here are your thinner canvases like this. They're not the thick 2-inch gallery wrapped. And they look like this. I like them because they are already have gesso on them, and there's no need to put that on there unless you want a different texture. So everybody's different, everybody does different things. Some people like to wet behind there before they start. Fluid art, I don't use it. Gesso. I tried that at the very beginning, and it just was an extra step that I didn't feel like I needed. I got the same results not using it. And everybody's different. Again, every artist, there's other artists out there that do totally different things than I do. I'm just telling you what I do, so what works for me. When I first began, there was a number of different canvases that are out there that you can choose from, and it really just depends on what you're looking at doing. If you're wanting to do quite a few canvases at a very lower price, these thinner ones are a nice opportunity for you. You can buy a pack of these for 10 bucks, and there's 10 of them. Sometimes there's like, oh, this one happened to be 8. Yeah, I can't even count. But 8 of them, sometimes there's 10, sometimes there's 5. Usually there's a deal going on, whether that's at Michael's or Hobby Lobby or wherever you get your supplies at. Those are just happen to be where I get mine supplies at, here up in Sioux City, Iowa. There's also these types of canvases right here that are the super thin ones. And let me just kind of show you, there's a big panel of them. So the thing that I thought about with these is that it would be super easy, super fun to do something thin. They're fairly inexpensive to work with. But what you have to be cautious of is if you're pouring on these, they actually warp. And I know you can't see this one as well, but there it does warp. My bigger ones I actually threw away because they were warped. There's too much paint, it was too wet, and it just warped. But you can spray the back with water, put them on the ground, and then have books on either side, and let them go back to their original. But for me personally, I stopped using these specifically because of that. I was frustrated with the fact that they started warping in the center, and then my paint would spill over to the sides with as much paint as we use in fluid art. So anyway, that's those. You can also get bigger ones like this, right? And the thinner ones in a package. This is also Fine Touch, Master Touch. Yep, Fine Touch, yep, Master Touch. That's that. And then the one that I'm going to be utilizing today in another painting is this Artist Loft Gallery Wrap. And that's this thicker 1-2-inch one. And I really like how it's done behind here because it's tucked up under. There's a second layer of wood
And it has a brace in the middle as well. So I like those for my larger paintings. And then you can also see behind me, this is a 4x5 inch. So 4x5 foot, not inch, canvas. And for my bigger canvases, I will either get Master Touch or I'll get the Artist Loft. So whichever one is really on sale, that's the one I tend to get. I think this one happens to be Master Touch. So for watching, don't forget to click the notification bell and to subscribe to my channel. Have a great day and we'll talk to you later. Bye for now.
Thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe and comment down below. Tell me what you liked about this, what you'd like to see in the future. And then of course, don't forget to click the notification bell so that way you can get notifications when I get a new video up. Thanks everyone. Have a great day. Bye for now.